Ida Kartika Sari, was born in Blitar. She graduated from Universitas Brawijaya and she continued her study in IPB University. Now she's interested in small-scale fisheries management in Indonesia. Now it's time to invite Bu Wahida, I think, to share about competition that occurred in Indonesian small-scale fishery. Bu Wahida, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Bu.
20 minutes will be yours and I will notify you 5 minutes before the end of your lecture.
Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. I am Wahida Kartika Sari. Today I'd like to present my paper titled Small Scale Fisheries Competition in Piggy Fishing. Most of small scale fisheries are multi-species and multi-gear, so that small scale fisheries management is very complex. Moreover, information on small scale fisheries is also limited. Therefore, information on small scale fisheries is indispensable for sustainable fisheries management planning. That's why this study is important to support sustainable fisheries management. This study, I'm first to describe the condition of small scale fisheries. Primarily examine the diversity of the catch. The second, to assess the level of utilization of fish resources. And the last, to clusterize fishing gear in piggy fishing port based on catch species. This study held in October until December 2014 at piggy fishing port. And then this is the data. The type of data, the first number of fishing gear, second fish species, and the last, the number of catches. The data for small-scale fisheries for this study is only the fishing gear that operate on fishing fleet under 5 gross ton, and the data was obtained from fish landing report in 2011 until 2014. I used 3 data analyze, the first diversity of fish catches, kemudian and then fishing gear productivity, and the last fishing gear competition. I used the Shannon Wiener index to get the diversity value. If the value of H approaches 0, it means the fish diversity is low, and then if the H value approaches 1, it means the diversity is high. And then about data analysis fishing gear productivity, the productivity of fishing gear is calculated by catch per unit effort, or CPUE. CPUE is a measure or relative abundance as indicator of abundance of fish resources. If a trend CPUE goes up, indicating that the fish exploitation are developing, and if CPUE trend is downward, indicating that effort leading to overfishing. And last, about fishing gear competition, IUVT of fishing gear is calculated by catch per unit. Principal component analysis was combined with cluster analysis. Cluster analysis was performed like this picture with the hierarchical cluster analysis method. The grouping is based on similarity fishing gear and fishing target. And then cluster analysis is calculated based on species composition of each fishing gear. Analysis research then used to determine proximity fishing gear relationship. And then this is a result. The type of fishing gear operated by 5 Groston fleet in Prigi fishing port are gillnet, handline, and then monofilament gillnet. There are several type of fish landed on Prigi fishing port. The dominant species is Katsuonus pelamis, Trisurus lepturus, and Sardidella lemuru. The Katsuonus pelamis is dominant for gillnet, while Trisurus lepturus dominate on handline, and Sardinella lemuru dominate on monofilament gillnet. This is a diversity of fish catches. The diversity of gillnet is tend to increase year by year, while the diversity of handline is tend to stable, and the diversity of monofilament gillnet is decreased year by year. The result of this study indicate that competition between fishing gear during the last 5 years have changed. These changes are thought to be caused by change in catch composition and diversity fish landed at Prigi fishing port. And then this is a result about fishing gear productivity. You can see that CPUE of gillnet is tend to decrease and CPUE handline and monofilament gillnet is stable. But CPUE handline in 2013 increasing sharply. It's because Trisurus lepturus is increasing too. And the last, this is a result of fishing gear competition. Fishing gear occupied in one cluster mean that they have relatively similar catch diversity. From the dendrogram, we can see that monofilament gillnet is closer to handline than gillnet. This indicate that monofilament gillnet and handline competed to have the same target species. In the near future, we need to consider proper management tools to avoid conflict between this gear. This is a conclusion. The first, each fishing gear has differences in trend of species composition during 2010 until 2014. The second, fish production of small scale fisheries is tend to stable except for handline in 2013. And the last, species composition of monofilament gillnet and handline is quite similar compared to species composition of gillnet. Thank you very much. Now I return it to the moderator.
Thank you very much, Bu Wahida. I think everybody is agree now that the second lecture was also interesting.